Be prepared, people.
Okay. We're doing a skit.
Yes.
It's Monty Python skit.
Your job is to guess our accents.
We have really good accents.
Really stellar accents. Yes.
At the end, you can guess.
Okay.
For a prize.
No prize.
very passable bit of risotto.
Nothing like a good glass of Chateau de Chatelet, hey, Josiah?
You're right there, Obadiah.
Who would have thought 30 years ago we'd all be sitting here drinking a Chateau de Chatelet? Eh?
And then, Liz, we'd be glad to have the press of a cup of tea.
A cup of cold tea.
Without the milk or sugar.
Or tea.
And a cracked cup and all.
Oh, we never even had a cup. We used to have to drink out of a rolled up newspaper.
The best we could manage was a soft good piece of duck cloth.
But you know, we were happy in those days, though we were poor.
Because we were poor. My old dad used to tell me money doesn't buy you happiness, son.
Aye, he was right.
Aye, he was.
I was happier then when I had nothing. We used to live in this tiny little house with the great big holes in the roof.
House? You were lucky to have a house. We used to live in one room, all 26 of us. No furniture, half the floor was missing, and we used to all have to huddle in the corner for fear of falling through the cracks.
Hey, you were lucky to have a room. We used to live in the corridor.
Oh, we used to dream of living in the corridor. Would have been a palace to us. We used to live in an old water tank. On a rubbish tip, if we got woke up every morning by having a load of rotting fish dumped all over us. House?
Huh. Well, when I say a house, it was only really a hole in the ground covered with a tarpaulin. But it was a house to us.
We were evicted from our hole in the ground. We had to go and live in a lake.
You were lucky to live in a lake. There were 150 of us living in a shoebox out in the middle of the road.
Cardboard box?
Aye.
You were lucky. We used to live for 3 months in a paper bag in a septic tank. We used to have to get up at 6 in the morning, clean the paper bag, eat a crust of stale bread, go to work to the mill, 14 hours a day, week in, week out, for 6 pence a week. And when we got home, Dad would thrash us to sleep with his belt.
Luxury. We used to have to get out of the lake at 6 o'clock in the morning, clean the lake, eat a handful of hot gravel, go to the mill for 20 hours a day, and when we got home, our dad would set the dogs on us and thrash us to sleep with a broken bottle if we were lucky.
Well, of course, we had it tough. We used to have to get up out of the shoebox at 12 o'clock at night and lick the road clean with our tongue. We had 2 bits of cold gravel, worked 24 hours a day at the mill for 6 pence every 4 years. And when we got home, our dad would slice us in two with a bread knife.
Right. Well, we had to get up at 10 o'clock at night, half an hour before we went to bed, drink a cup of sulfuric acid, work 29 hours a day down mill, and pay a mill owner permission to come to work. And when we got home, Dad and Ma would kill us and dance about our graves singing hallelujah.
When you try to tell the kids this day nowadays, they won't believe you.
They won't.
They won't.
Dracula.
Excuse me, Italian Dracula who turns into an angry pirate.